Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television for Wednesday, January 5th, 2010. In the pre-market this morning, coming up to 6 a.m., we've got stock index futures below fair value, Dow futures down about 50 points, so we are looking for some selling at the open on Wednesday morning. Now, we're still waiting for that divergence between the VIX and the S&P 500 to correct itself. Right now, the VIX is still on a buy signal, and that would not change unless we close below 1696. So the VIX on a buy signal should equal the S&P 500 on a sell signal, and that is not the case. We have that discrepancy, the divergence that was developed over the Christmas holidays. Yesterday was an inside day for the S&P 500. A daily close below 1252.77 would give us a sell signal for the index and for the majority of stocks in the S&P 500. Looking at the S&P Bank Index, bank stocks still doing well. We need to close below 147.08 on Wednesday to change that. NASDAQ 100, inside day yesterday, looking for a close below 22.21.16. We've got CES going on in Las Vegas this week, and should expect a lot of technology news, a lot of activity in this sector this week. For the SOX index, we're looking for a close below 409.94, still not able to break out above the previous high. Cloud computing, we had some strength on Monday, Tuesday, basically an inside day. We need to close below 52.81. Cramer's Mobile Internet Index is still on a buy signal. Our credit card index is still on a sell signal. Stocks were up yesterday, but not enough to give us a new buy signal for this index. Copper stocks are still holding up fairly well. Fertilizer stocks still holding up fairly well. Weight loss stocks still seeing some selling in that sector. Looking at gold stocks, a sharp down day yesterday. Not only was it the gold stocks, this is gold fields, but we saw selling in silver stocks as well, and we haven't seen that in months. We saw some weakness last month, not enough to give us a new sell signal. So we're seeing selling in silver stocks, and we haven't seen that in quite a while. Looking at the 30-year bond, we're still on a buy signal, looking for a close below 120.52, still not able to break out and trade above the upper channel line. Looking at the U.S. dollar, we need to close above 80.43 to give us a buy signal. For the euro, we need to close below 131.70 to give us a sell signal. Taking a look at the six main commodity ETFs we follow, starting with gasoline. We're still on a buy signal here, but we came down to the lower channel line yesterday. A close below 41.08 would give us a sell signal on Wednesday. For natural gas, an inside day yesterday, still not able to take out the previous high. We need a close below 5.78 to give us a sell signal on Wednesday. For crude oil, we're now on a sell signal. We're down again in the pre-market this morning. We need to close above 38.86. I don't think that's going to happen. And so we should look for a down move in crude oil for the next couple of weeks. Looking at copper, still on a buy signal, still closing above the upper channel line. We need to close below 57.16 on the copper ETF to give us a sell signal. For gold, big down day yesterday. Couldn't take out those previous highs. And so we're on a sell signal for the GLD. We need to close above 137 to change that. And for the SLV, we're just on the edge of a sell signal. Close below 29.02 on Wednesday would give us a new sell signal. Just a couple of 60-minute charts. We're looking at an S&P 500 that's still above the hourly flypaper channel. If we start breaking down below 1256, we assume that the bears have taken control. We're on an intraday sell signal. The trend is on a sell signal right now. That would change if we start to close above 1270.20. Certainly don't think that's going to happen at the open. So we're looking for a breakdown below yesterday's low to tell us that something new is going on. And last up this morning, just take a quick look at the VIX. The VIX traded and closed right into the hourly flypaper channel yesterday. That's a neutral position. If we break out above yesterday's high, that would be bearish for stocks. So above 1825, below yesterday's low would be bullish for stocks. And so we assume if we're going to see some selling at the open on Wednesday morning, we expect the VIX to move higher. And then really confirmation that something new is developing here. We're looking for a breakout above 1825 on an hourly basis on Wednesday. Okay, that's all for today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television. If you want to know more about what we do and the other charts that we provide, please visit theuptrend.com. Otherwise, the next time you'll hear from me is on Thursday morning. So have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Thursday morning.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television. For more information on our charts and services, please visit theuptrend.com.